A long, long time ago, in a galaxy far away, Naboo was under an attack. And I thought me and Qui-Gon Jinn could talk the Federation into maybe cutting them a little slack. But their response, it didn't thrill us. They locked the doors and tried to kill us. We escaped from that gas, then met Jar Jar and Boss Nass. We took a bongo from the scene and we went to feed to see the Queen. We all wound up on Tatooine. That's where we found this boy. Oh my, my, this here Anakin guy. Maybe Vader someday later, now he's just a small fry. And he left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Did you know this junkyard slave isn't even old enough to shave? But he can use the Force, they say. Do you see him hitting on the Queen? Though he's just 9 and she's 14. Yeah, he's probably gonna marry her someday. Jedi. Now we finally got to Coruscant, the Jedi Council we knew would want to see how good the boy could be. So we took him there and we told the tale how his midichlorians were off the scale and he might to. I frankly would have liked to stay. We all fought in that epic war, and it wasn't long at all before little Hotshot flew his plane and saved the day. And in the end, some Gungans died, some ships blew up and some pilots fried. A lot of folks were croaking, the battle droids were broken, and the Jedi I admire most met up with Darth Maul and now he's toast. Well, I'm still here and he's a ghost. I guess I'll train this boy. And I was singing, my, my, this here Anakin guy. Maybe Vader someday later, just a small fry. And he left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Soon I'm gonna be a Jedi. Anakin guy. Maybe Vader someday later, now he's just a small fry. And he left his home and kissed his mommy goodbye, saying soon I'm gonna be a Jedi.